I grew up in a, I would like to think, a very progressive household. And, you know, I was surrounded by an environment of empowered women, I would say, from childhood through the early phase of my professional life. But somehow, it wasn't until I got to PSI and began working directly on issues of reproductive health and family planning that this penny dropped for me. I mean, this is the work of an era which will occupy good-thinking people for a long time. And it's all about raising the lives of girls and women, and by the way, their men partners and their communities. So how could you not be passionate about this? I mean, for me, it was, I have to say, it's been late in coming, but I feel it strongly. I'm Carl, President and CEO of Population Services International. PSI has been around for 45 years. It's a nonprofit working to make it easier for people in the developing world to lead healthier lives, and we've been working in family planning, reproductive health, HIV, malaria, child survival, tuberculosis, a whole range of issues. Too often in public health, the approach has been just tell people what to do and they'll see the wisdom of doing it because it's obviously in their benefit. But it doesn't work that way. It doesn't work that way for you or for me, and it certainly doesn't work that way for people around the world, particularly in the developing world. So why not use those tools of communication and marketing to help people understand why they have a benefit and an incentive to adopt a healthy behavior? I think our humanity calls us to reach out to people who are in need. There seems to be a lot of misery and a lot of poverty, and this organization is about trying to do something about that. And I'm really proud of it. Now it's possible to take this 21st century moment when there's a lot of private resources available, and more than ever, there are people who are aware of the world around them. We're networked, we're connected more than ever, and people are interested in really impactful solutions to global problems that they can touch, that they can affect, that they can see from their investment right through to the solution. And I think this sort of collective of new philanthropists gives us the chance to do that in the global health space that we're familiar with, but also in the broader space of ending extreme poverty in the world. I just find it to be an incredibly inspiring moment. We can end extreme poverty in our lifetime by lifting up girls and women, by removing the barriers that exist to the impoverished around the world, and by bringing new energy and new ideas and new creativity to age-old problems. And I want to be a part of that.